how do I prepare for bachelor's of design or master's of design? And how do I prepare for NID, SEED and NIFT?
First of all, congratulations for choosing to do this. It's beautiful, like the journey in front of you, it's only going to get more and more rewarding as the years go by. I mean, I think like all the things that people, that we hear people complaining about, yaar ki matlab bade exams hain aur kya karwa rahe hain humse, and like that is not a problem that we have to deal with, right? What we deal with is, oh my god, there's so much I want to do and I don't have enough time to do it, and that's a great problem to have in life. So congratulations for having chosen to do that. In terms of preparing for the college, I would definitely say for a bachelor's degree, definitely work on your visual skills a lot, because you do not have that body of work which a master's student has, right? Because the portfolio of two bachelor's students will not look very extremely different from each other. Yeah. So definitely make sure you're entering college with really strong visual skills. Again, that being said, you don't have to be the most amazing drawer, painter there is, right? You have to be good in understanding how visuals work. I would really recommend what I was talking about earlier, pick up personal projects and work for them, right? If you feel like there is somebody, like you have people around you for whom you see a problem and you feel like you can develop a product that can be a solution, work on that, and you have a great faculty and people around you who can give you feedback on your own product and make it great and make it better, right? Start practicing the process of design. Start practicing thinking like a designer, working like a designer. That will only build your, make your portfolio stronger. I'm looking at that table because that table looks like it's bachelor's students, yeah. So definitely do that, right? I mean, whatever Mitesh sir tells you in terms of visuals is like you are sorted in that. So he has done his part of the job. Like he can guarantee that you go have great skills if you work well with him. What remains is you as an individual and how you will develop that. Right? Because, I mean, probably like colleges are looking for the greatest painter there is, but people who hire designers are not looking for that. If I want a painter, I'll get a painter. Right? I'm getting a designer because I want a designer's job done. So start practicing how that happens. Yeah? And start putting your work out there. I mean, and there are many, many platforms right now. There's Behance, there's Dribbble, there's Instagram. Start putting it out there. Start getting feedback from people. And be very, very humble when you're asking for feedback. Right? I mean, you might want to make something of red color, but if I am your user and I'm scared of the color red, I will not take it. And that's it. And then what you think about that color does not matter. Right? So, couple of things. Work on your visual skills. Develop yourself as an individual. Pick up projects you really care about. Put those projects out there and get feedback from people. Yep. And I am not even talking about being socially aware, because that I'm taking for granted is happening. Yeah. Because we don't design in isolation. We design in a society. And we have to understand what's happening in the society right now. Yeah? So, I mean, however great your Photoshop is, or however great your Illustrator is, if you do not know who is the finance minister and what are his policies for your own country. Yeah? Cool. That. And for people, this seems like the master's degree. Yeah? So, for people who are in there, who are applying for a master's degree, in design, I would say the first thing is to take off this lens of maine abhi tak kuch nahi kiya, right? You are choosing to do a master's degree because you have something in you and it has come out in different ways. It has probably been your art journal, it has probably been an invitation card you've designed for a friend, or anything like that, like whatever it is that you've done, it has probably been your writing blog, your poems that you've written. Yeah, reflect on what it is that has made you want to be a designer. Think about what are your strengths, what are your skills, and hone that. Yeah, I was not good at drawing, and if I was going to compete with my competitors on drawing, I would have lost. right? But I knew for a fact that I was great in communicating knowledge to people. I was great in understanding people learn processes. And I approached, I still do, like even at college, I am doing that. I'm focusing on what my strengths are. Because that is how I'm going to be an asset to the world, not by playing someone else's game when it's not mine to begin with. So I mean, that's something I would definitely recommend the master students do who are going to prepare next year. That like, again, like being somebody who's trained visually and being somebody who's aware of what's going on in the world is a given. Right? I am talking beyond that. And learning how to prepare visually, learning how to know what's happening socially, there are hajar resources out there. All you have to do is Google search, ask Mitesh sir, ask people around you, and you'll figure out how to get there. But please understand, like, you know, I mean, 15 people make it. And those 15 people are individuals and humans, right? Who are fully formed in many ways, are open to learning, are humble and want to accomplish something for the world and figure out what it is that will make you be that person, right? Because design is beautiful in a way that it puts you on the driving seat, right? It says ki, what is it that you want to do, and let me give you the skills to do it. Yeah, now the question is for all of you to understand that if you're on the driving seat, where will you take that car? Thank you.